We have a mic. Good evening. It's a pleasure to see each of you here for our Sabbath evening Vespers music concert. We welcome those of you who are on our live stream. And while we're reticent to see the Sabbath hours slip away, we can say it's been a high day, has it not? Been such a blessing to experience this Sabbath. And we trust that the blessing is not done. That God has a blessing in store for you that you might receive through the music that's shared this evening. Before we begin, I would ask your indulgence that we might pray together. Father in heaven, I just want to thank you so much for giving us this Sabbath day. They're all special, but this one has just been more so. And we're asking that as we depart these Sabbath hours, that we might not be departing from your presence. But indeed, we ask, Father, I crave one more blessing before these hours pass. So thank you for hearing our need and for responding because you're who you are. And we offer this program now to you. For Jesus' sake, amen.
The daily trials and troubles of this world can eat up our time and attention and our thoughts. But where does God lie in all of this? Where does he fit into our tough daily schedule? In Matthew 9, Jesus promises that if we lay all of our burdens at the foot of the cross, if we give Jesus all of our troubles, then he will fit together all of the pieces of our life.
Is a calming and powerful song that reminds a lot of people that they are not broken. There are a lot of places in life where it seems like everything is going wrong and that nothing can be fixed. And a lot of people assume that once something bad happens to them, their life will be ruined. But what they don't realize is that God can fix anything. The crooked can be made straight if we believe. God can fix it. He can fix anything. God's glory is an amazing solution that can help or fix anyone who believes.
This is a traditional song in Christianity. It was written by a former captain of a slave ship called named John Newton, who had a collision with Christ. He wrote this song as a testimony to the mercy, grace, and love of God that changed his life. And its name is Amazing Grace.
Thank you. actually was? Well, that's what happens when Jesus comes into your life and brightens it up. The song we're going to be performing first is called Within the Darkest Night.
Now, I want to just ask you guys a question. Raise your hand if you have ever been through a tough time in your life. I think we should all be raising our hands because we live in a sinful world where, unfortunately, bad things happen and we go through tough times. And a lot of times when we're going through those times, it's always good to have that friend to lean on, or that parent, or that sibling, or someone who's always there for you. It's always nice to have that. But I also want to tell you that we have an ultimate friend, and that is Jesus. He is the friend that's always by our side when our heart is weary and burdened, when we're down in the lowest moments of our life. He's the one that comes and sits beside us and picks us up again. And he not just picks us up, but he carries us through those tough moments. So this next piece that we will be presenting to you guys is You Raise Me Up, and I hope you're blessed by it.
Thank you. A capriccio is a song that is supposed to be fun, and it is really a fun piece, and it really expresses the joy of happiness. Now, think of a moment when you were the most happy, when you really felt free and just felt pure joy. Now, when you listen to the song, think of that moment.
Thank you. One of my biggest fears has been not knowing, whether it be not knowing who I am or what God's plan is for me. Often, we as humans have this fear and face times in our lives when we don't know. The unknown can be scary and uncomfortable. But in those dark times, I've learned to remember the words of our Father, "Do not be afraid, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by your name. You are mine."
I would like to introduce to you a song of wonder and happiness. We're going to be singing about making disciples of all the nations. As we sing this song, listen to the words.
and I'm sure you'll be as blessed as I am every time I hear this song. We are now singing Go Into the World.
A man once said that praising God was not made for his benefit, but for ours. And I have to say I agree with him. Every time I praise God, it brightens my day, and it helps me to be a more positive person. It reminds me of the times that he has led me in the past, and it encourages me that he will lead me in the future. As we sing our next praise to God, I ask you to take this time to reflect on the times that God has led you and guided you in the past. This is Lift Up Your Heads.
Open up and let the King of Glory come in.
Final choir song for tonight is Holy Is He, and this song is just a reminder to the world that there is no one holier than God, and that he's like a shepherd that leads us when we're astray, and he pardons our iniquities, and he heals us from within, and it just truly shows us that he really does love and care for us.
is Toccata on King's Weston. This is a hymn also known as At the Name of Jesus. The words are written by Carolyn Noel in 1870, and they are praising God for his might and power. The music is also very strong and inspiration, and I hope you are blessed by it.
Bow your heads with me for closing prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this Bells and Choirs group. Please help us to have a good rest of the graduation, and thank you that it was such a great Sabbath. Amen.